Good morning, students, and welcome to 4-Star English High School Online Studies. Myself, Sheikh Tahseen. Students, many of us enjoying eating many kinds of fruits, but our favorite ones are strawberries. So, today we are going to learn about this delicious fruit in Unit 1, Poem Number 4, Strawberries of English Standard 5th. Introduction of the poem. Strawberries are red heart-shaped fruits. They are rich in vitamin C, iron and other minerals. Strawberry is widely appreciated for its aroma, bright red color, juicy texture and sweetness. It is consumed in large quantities either fresh or in such prepared as jam, juice, pies, ice cream, milkshake and so on. So, with this information, let's also understand when and where do we get strawberries. In Maharashtra, you know students, in India up to 85% of the strawberries are cultivated in Mahabaleshwar. In recent years, strawberries are being cultivated successfully in the plains of Maharashtra around Pune, Nasik and Sangli. Seasons being from October to November and April to May, some of which are imported from California in the month of June, are planted in nurseries in place like Vai. You know students, Mahabaleshwar and Vai are the part of Satara district, and of course California is in North America. Now let's begin the poem. So here we have a short and sweet poem. First I'll read the whole poem and then explain. Strawberry that in gardens grow, strawberry that in gardens grow, are plump and juicy fine. But sweeter far as wise men know, but sweeter as far wise men know, spring from the woodland vine. No need for bowl or silver spoon, no need for bowl or silver spoon, sugar or spice or cream. Has the wild berry plucked in June, has the wild berry plucked in June, beside the trickling stream. Now reading of the first stanza. Strawberries that in gardens grow are plump and juicy fine, but sweeter far as wise men know, spring from the woodland vine. Here new words. Plump means big or fat. Next word, vine, means a creeping plant grows up or over things. Now let's see the explanation of the first stanza. In the first stanza, the poet is making a comparison between the strawberries grown in gardens and strawberries grown in the woodlands near the stream. The poet says, strawberries grown in gardens are big, juicy and fine, and woodland strawberries are particularly known for its aroma and its juicy texture. Garden strawberries are sweet and woodland strawberries are much sweeter in taste. Strawberries grown in woodlands are climbing on the tree, that is vine. Reading of the second stanza. No need for bowl or silver spoon, sugar or spice or cream, has the wild berry plucked in June beside the trickling stream. Here, new words, spice means a substance made from a plant used to give a special flavor to food, and trickling means flowing slowly. Now, explanation of the stanza. As per the poet, to eat such a delicious fruit, one should not use any bowl, silver spoon or should add any sugar, spice or cream. Rather, one should be like a wise man who knows that the strawberries grown on vine near a trickling stream in the month of June are much sweeter and completely ripen. Hence, can be eaten directly from the tree. Now, let's summarize the poem. The poet says that though the strawberries that grow in gardens are big and juicy fine, वाइज मैन नो दैट दोज डैट ग्रो ऑन द वाइन्स वुड्स आर स्वीटर. There is no need for a bowl or a silver spoon, sugar, spice or cream. If one eats the wild strawberry that has been plucked in June from a near trickling stream. So here we have come to end of the poem. Thank you, students.